Woof.
Woof, woof, woof.
How you doing, Adam?
You know what? The thing is, I don't like theme parks. I don't like zoos. I'm going to be the grumpy old man in this video.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You don't like theme parks or zoos, huh?
No, I've never been on a roller coaster, to tell you the truth.
You've never been on a roller coaster?
Nope, never.
Okay, that was not what I was expecting.
Yeah.
I was expecting you to say, like, oh, I don't like roller coasters, but never been on one.
Never even
wild.
Been on one.
So, yeah, this is Planet Zoo, Adam.
Well, why would you want to make your own zoo, Hayden?
I love animals, so actually this is 100% my game.
Oh, really? Wow, okay.
Oh, some of my animals are hungry, so...
Oh, see, you're not even feeding your animals.
Let's just start off by saying the AI in this game could use some work.
Wait, what AI? Like, what...
So you've got keepers that have to take care of your animals. I'm trying to spot one in here for us.
Okay. And you hire those individually, or do they scale?
Yeah, you hire them. Oh, there we go.
Hey, there he is.
And they have to go around and, like, fill all of the food.
Do trays. They have a backstory?
I mean, you could give them one. This is Neil Kitson.
Ooh, I like
he's
name.
Very happy at work.
Oh, good.
But, like, this is hilarious. Why hasn't the savanna habitat been cleaned?
Is he asking that?
He is the one responsible for cleaning the savanna habitat.
Wait, so he had that thought.
Yeah.
But he's the one who's supposed to clean it?
Yeah, he's the one that's supposed to clean it.
Wow.
So,
what a weird worker.
Yeah, it's very strange. Also, like, our power sources are failing and the mechanics are not bothering to go fix them.
Wait, are you just bad at this game, Hayden?
No, the AI is really... sort of busted, but man, I cannot stop playing this game.
Really?
I have played something like 40 hours of Planet Zoo so far.
Wow. Well, what's your draw?
I love animals and I love builders, man. That's all it needs.
Okay. What's your number one favorite animal?
Orangutan.
Do you have an orangutan in the game?
I don't yet, because they're very expensive. I will say I have a comical amount of money right now. If you look down in the bottom left here, I have... Whoa. $600,000.
That's a good chunk.
This is very much like a normal builder where you just end up sort of running away with money by the end.
Well, buy yourself an orangutan.
So the problem is the orangutan is this different type of money, conservation credits, of which I only have 400.
Oh.
And this is actually fascinating. This is the first time I've played this game since the actual release has happened.
Uh-huh.
And so... when I was playing, pretty much all of the animals came from this thing, the Frontier Zoo, which is just their catch-all for, like, their developer spawned.
Oh.
But all of these animals are coming from other players. So you can see they're...
Wait, you're actually, like, buying and trading with other players?
Yeah, with other players. These names down here. And so that's fascinating because...
That is kind of cool.
Back when I was playing before... it was almost impossible to get conservation credits. You basically have to release your own animals into the wild. And so I have done some of that, and I have like a giraffe. The giraffes cost conservation credits. In fact, I have two giraffes. I have three now because they had a baby. I can turn our time back on. So yeah, I've got three little giraffes. Those all cost conservation credits. If I were to release one of them in the wild, I would get, once it grows up, I would get conservation credits back, which is neat. But that was the only thing before. You could release them in the wild and get like 40 at a time.
Mm-hmm.
I think now that the player market is up, you can actually sell them for conservation credits to other players and get way more than I was getting in the pre-release period.
Wow. Okay.
So that's neat. But yeah, if we go and look at orangutans, which I can't remember what they're actually called because they have a Bornean
monkey.
No, please, they're apes.
Ah.
Didn't you learn this from ancestors, Adam?
No, I didn't.
So yeah, these are 600 each, 700 each.
Oh,
this one is 4,000 for like a top tier orangutan.
That is from somebody.
Yeah, this is from
Why did they
Atlantis.
Price that orangutan so high?
Probably because they want 4,000 for their zoo so that they can do some cool stuff.
Wow, that is...
So yeah, I've got... Oh, sorry. I clicked on the research tab by accident. We have researched that snake. So yeah, I have 70 animals here in the zoo.
Okay.
So I can get rid of this ostrich, actually, because this ostrich just grew up.
Yeah, nobody
likes
this.
You can see it's a young adult now. And so if I release it to the wild, I'll get 31 credits. I'm pretty sure there's a way, but maybe I'm wrong. I think there's a way to sell the animal. Maybe if I move it to the trade center. I've not done this yet because, as I said, the servers were not
online before release.
Oh, yeah, because
then there's
exhibit
release. Trading at the bottom left.
Yeah, well, that's that's all over the tiny animals. They go into a thing called a small exhibit. I can show you some. I've got a reptile house that I built over here. So, yeah, I constructed this thing out of pieces. This is very much like Planet Coaster. You can build entire buildings out of pieces that you set up.
Okay.
So I could just like add a branch onto here if I wanted.
That's a weird design choice, but
or you
okay.
know, add a African decorative rock in front.
That's also weird.
All sorts of options. There's like four themes or five themes, I think. Five themes. I've been using the classic theme a lot because it's like this old Victorian curio right. theme.
I like it.
So then you can go inside your buildings, where I have wow. all of these snakes. This is my snake home. we've got a common
death
adder.
Can you feed it a live rat right now?
No, he gets fed automatically. It doesn't get that minute, but I do have this death adder. He's hiding right now.
Oh, there he is.
Maybe I can get in close and we can...
Is he purple?
It's because he's selected.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, he's hiding under this rock right now. Not the best thing if somebody wanted to come see him. He's just kind of...
I'm actually surprised. The fidelity is pretty nice when you zoom all the way in.
It's great.
Wow.
You can really get up close with all of your animals. I have a couple of bear pens. They'll climb on top of this shelter, which is really funny.
Nice.
They'll also climb trees, so
you
can put like these tall trees in here, and they'll just climb all the way to the top and hang out.
That's cool.
It's really fun.
I have a question.
Yeah.
How many animals can escape from your zoo?
All of them, if you're not good about maintaining your concrete barriers. So that's another complaint I have about this game: is your barriers just melt. It's
what do you mean melt?
I've heard about the time fall in Death Stranding, which is like this rain that falls that makes everything age. That's pretty much what happens to your barriers
here.
Like, look at these holes in my barrier.
Do you think it's the people who are coming to look at the exhibit and
no,
they're
it's just
putting
like
holes
they
in
just
them?
Get old and like it'll happen even if okay. So like I have turtles over here,
uh-huh.
and my turtles will just like. The barriers will break. You're like, what did those turtles do?
That's weird.
I got these little baby turtles.
Those are kind of cute.
We could get real close on these baby turtles. I've got even the empty pens. I've got these empty pens over here.
Uh-huh.
And I just got a warning. You can see it over here. Habitat 19 has damaged barriers. There are no animals in this barrier. It's just a big concrete wall, and it's like falling apart.
That's weird.
And so I have to like send my mechanic over to fix a barrier for nothing. There's no animals in here.
That
part is strange. But
okay.
I don't know. It's neat. You can I've got this big savanna, this African savanna with wildebeests and giraffes.
Ooh, giraffe.
And I've got these. This like elevated walkway so all of my guests can really get a good look.
Can you see how many guests you have in your park?
Yes,
right
we
now?
Have 2,966.
Oh, that seems like a lot.
And
how much are you charging for tickets?
A lot. It's actually funny. Your guests will be like, man, these values are real good. I am charging $35 to get into the zoo, and they're still like, ooh, those ticket prices are pretty low, which is why I have a comical amount of money right now. I've got like this very nice geometric park layout. I've got a monorail that people can ride. All of this was built by me. This was just an empty plaza when I got in
here.
And
it looks like the bounds are pretty large.
Oh, it's huge. Especially, I went back and played some Planet Coaster over the weekend, and the park boundaries for that are way smaller than this. So that's fascinating. I've got this nice little entryway area with some statues.
Oh, that's so pretty. The hippos.
I've got all of these trees were planted by me.
So you're enjoying it. You're digging it.
It's amazing.
You're
man.
Deep in.
I love it. I built this shelter out of like rock pieces.
Looks like the Lion King.
To look like a cave. Oh, funny that you mentioned that.
Yes.
I can Pride Rock. This is a Steam Workshop item that somebody made.
I was about to say, I was like, man, somebody's going to get sued for that.
It's, let's see.
Credit goes to
Furnith 93.
All right, great. Thank you.
Yeah. They, you can add Pride Rock. That's I've actually hilarious. Been waiting to adopt lions so that I can add Pride Rock into this area right here.
Wow. Okay. Is this game of the year contender for you, Hayden?
No, because it's buggy. But like honestly, yes. You know how sometimes you have like a game of the year that's like, oh, this is the best game this year, and then you have like your personal game of the year.
Oh yeah.
That you're like, this is the game that I've played the most.
Uh-huh.
This is my personal game of the year.
Wow. Okay.
I'm really enjoying just like hanging out, watching my crocs or griles. I actually don't know what this animal is in real life.
They
can swim right up to this this glass barrier here. All my my guests can admire them. It's got problems, like the keeper AI and all that. Like we've talked about a bunch of it already,
but you're still having fun.
But man, I like cannot stop playing this game.
Wow. Okay, it hooked you.
Yeah, it is. Just amazing, and like the fidelity when you get real close. Like I could just watch. Look, I got my wolf playing with his chew toy.
Yeah, hit play.
Yeah, we can
see him move around. Looks like it's animated. Okay, huh?
He's gonna hang out with his chew toy, I guess. And we can you can just like put a tracking camera on them and watch them. So he'll just walk around for a while.
I see a baby over there. Do the animals have sex?
They're not in front of you.
Oh, no. Okay.
But they do get pregnant and have babies. In fact, you can't make money off of any animals that you have bought or like conservation credits. Like, you can't just like buy a bunch of animals up and then trade them off. You have to actually have animals reproduce. And then that's what I was saying before. I could release that ostrich to the wild.
Wow. Okay. That seems like a weird addition, but yeah.
It's like a... I don't know, man. I just find it fascinating. Oh, I think now that this ostrich is in here. Yeah, so we can now, I think, trade this guy out for some amount of money.
Huh. All right.
But I don't know. Yeah, there we go. So we can increase the price down here.
You should ask for $299.
Yeah?
Or $2,999, just like that.
We can ask for $10,000.
No, do $2,999, because then you can get the orangutan.
This is a crappy ostrich. I don't think anybody's going to pay
that
much.
Money.
But that's it. So that none of that was active when I was playing pre-release. So this is actually fascinating because I was doing this every time and getting
just
like
releasing
15 credits at a time and being like, man, this is it's real hard to make money in this game.
Yeah.
It took me hours to grind up enough currency on like releasing tiny lizards into the wild to get these two giraffes. And I was so pumped when I did
grinding lizards for giraffes.
Yeah. Like I have some Nile monitors, over here. And at one point these Nile monitors had like 12 lizard kids and it took them like 6 years to grow up. And then they did. And I was like shipping them off 50 at a time.
Cool.
It is a really neat game. I highly recommend it to anybody who isn't Adam and doesn't hate theme parks and zoos.
Well, my last question is, how does it run?
It runs
zooming in and out. It's got a lot of fidelity.
Yeah, we're on a 2080 Ti and I'm on a 2080 Ti at home. It runs pretty good. I will say when it rains, the performance goes immediately to garbage.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, so most of the time, like we can see all these people walking around.
Yeah.
There's an impressive amount going on at any one time. You'll notice slowdown once in a while. Like if we start panning across all of these bridges and stuff, we get some screen tearing. We get a little bit of slowdown, but it's surprisingly good considering how well rendered all these animals are. Like,
yeah.
Look at that fur along
beautiful.
The back of its neck,
yeah.
That mane.
Cool.
Now we can watch this giraffe drink.
He's thirsty.
He's got to do that dumb splayed legs thing. That's Planet Zoo. It is a game that I really love.
Well, how much is this game you really love?
This is, I think, only $40.
Whoa.
It is also a bargain in that regard.
Okay.
We have some, I just noticed we have these heaters down here because it snows here in my zoo, and uh-huh. All of the Africa animals were not happy when it snowed.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It is a, I think, a $40 game. Knowing how Frontier operates, there will be like 100 expansions in a couple of years.
Hopefully, so get in on the ground floor.
Hopefully adding more animals and more themes and stuff like that.
Cool.
But yeah, I think it's already an amazing game. I think it's better than Planet Coaster was at launch.
Cool.
And if you really just want to like hang out and watch your watch some crocodiles walk around, I cannot recommend it enough.
All right, it's got the Hayden Dingman seal of approval.
Yeah, and that's rare. So yeah, let's end on this croc.
Just watch him drink. He's thirsty.
He's a beautiful, or she, it's a beautiful lady. So thank you, Adam.
Hey,
and
thank you.
Maybe you should ride a roller coaster sometime.
Nah.